Zoom in for me, please. Where is the pause? Oh, here's the pause. I need a sip of water after that. It's a bright cherry red. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And oh, I have a very teary eye. Today is another Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. It is number 62, I think. Yes. And I have some interesting finds this week, I think. And some that I think, really? These videos are based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist will be down in my description box, as well the community playlist that she was kind enough to create for people such as me who do these types of videos. So if you like these types of videos and hear, well, people talk about makeup, go binge watch the playlist. It is, as I said, listed down in my description box. Oh, the look I have on my face, I did film. I hope I won't forget to mention it at the end of the video, because I want to keep it a surprise to the end of the video. Leave down below which palette you think I did this look with. I'm curious. I'm very, very curious if you will guess it. So yeah, that's basically it. Check out my description box anyway for my sources. The products that I will mention today will be listed there as well. And before we go any further, last week I mentioned that my mother was in the hospital. And you guys were so, so sweet giving her well wishes and hoping that she would feel better soon. She is home and she is feeling much, much better. So we are very happy about that. So don't worry, she's okay. Also, my plan for Miss Muffet worked, but it's a bit too early to show her. So yeah, that one is coming as well. Let me just go to the side. I know I want to mention more, I just don't know what. I will, however, mention the lipstick that I have, because it is different than the one that is in the look. It is the Essence Instacare in the color Sandy Sunrise. They're very, very comfortable. They are like a tinted lip balm. They're so, so nice and hydrating. So, just so you know. Okay, let's go to... let's go to the side. I have some water here because I think I'll need it. Let's start with the first thing, which is ColourPop. This, which is the Going Coconuts. And I understand a lot of people are very, very excited about it. I'm not one of those people. This is more my aesthetic. I do love browns, though, but I kind of like the off-browns, you know, the pukey, diarrhea, those kind of browns. Those, or the very cool tones, you know, grayish-browns. Those are the types of browns that I like. This is not really it. However, when I saw this picture, the swatches, this looked so pretty. And it will probably look gorgeous on pale skin as well. But this picture grabbed my attention so, so much. That I know some of you are, well, more this color than my color. Let me know what you think, because I think this would look gorgeous on a darker skin tone. But that is me. There is a lot in the collection, as per usual, how ColourPop does it. A 9-pen eyeshadow palette, you have some lippies and all that goodness. There's a lot. Go check out the ColourPop website. I will leave it down below. Let me know what you think, though. I'm very, very curious to know what you think. Okay, let's go to Makeup Revolution next. Yes, they are not sitting still, are they? I have something from almost all the brands. So let's start with the Makeup Revolution and themselves, because they have collaborated again with Neth. And she is Polish. Yeah, she's a Polish Instagram sensation called Natalia Siewicz, I think. I hope I pronounce it correctly, but I'm not sure. I don't speak Polish. Well, I know slotty, but that's the only Polish word I know. And that's their currency, so yeah. Anyway, I know she did a first round, and the palettes that she had were like this. And from my understanding, it was a very good quality. So they have two eyeshadow palettes in the range, because there's actually... She's gorgeous, by the way. And there's actually... Let's see what is in there. The collection includes two eyeshadow palettes, a neutrals. Yeah. I actually think it's kind of colorful for a neutral palette. But again, neutrals for me are browns. Everything that is not brown is a color. That's how I look at it. So yeah, but yeah, you have the Neutrals shadow palette and the Let's Go Wild shadow palette. The palettes retail for 10 bucks, 12 euros or 15, no, 10 pounds, 12 euros or 15 bucks. There are also three face palettes. They retail for 5 pounds, 6 euros or 7 bucks. Two eyeliner and lip liner kits, same price as the face palette. And then three lipsticks. For also the same price, so 5 pounds, 6 euros and 7 bucks. The annoying thing is they also put pressed glitters in the palette. I don't know how many. I'm zooming in. Let's talk about the neutral one, because the neutral one kind of reminds me a little bit of the one that I have from Blushtribe, from Certify, is it Eternity? Yeah, the Eternity palette, my kind of nude palette. So for me, this is not a neutral palette, it's a nude palette, because it reminds me of nude lip colors, you know? And nude lip colors are not all brown lately. They're also pinkish nudes. I don't. Anyway, it kind of reminds me of that. So if you really liked the Certified palette, but you thought it was a bit too expensive, you could also, you know, try this on for size. So the Brights palette, I'm looking at the zoomed in picture now. At first glance, I really, really liked it. However, the shade that pops out for me is that kind of a limey green, and then the two pinky, noir, mauvey, purpley, dusty, I don't know what kind of colors. I think I asked if Burning Man, the red, was a shimmer or a matte, because the picture I see now does not show it, so I actually don't know, but it is probably a matte, which is actually very sad. It makes me sad. I love a red shimmer, but anyway. So yeah, the funny thing is, out of these two palettes, the one that actually grabs my attention is the neutrally one, which is kind of weird, but it is, I think it is the color layout. The blue is throwing me off a little bit, so I think that's it. So yeah, so the eyeshadow palettes, yeah, I don't know, guys. It's not really, they're pretty, but they're, I don't know, maybe it's the pictures, that could be it. The lippies look very pretty. I do have to say though that I am kind of, I do like lipsticks, but I like the slimmer lipsticks, because they're easier to apply. That's it. And then the pencils, yeah, look nice. I don't get excited about pencils, actually. And the blush, I think you had a blush, a bronzer and a highlight. Yeah, they look pretty as well. I like the packaging. I like the fact that it's cardboard and not plastic. I really like all that. So yeah, it's a nice collection, and I congratulate her on her second collab with Revolution. Let me know down below if you know her, if you follow her, if you are excited about the collection and all that goodness. So yeah, let's go next to iHeart Revolution, because they have two brand new chocolate bar palettes. You have the Fruit and Nut chocolate palette and the Truffle chocolate palette. And the reason I wanted to mention it is because I actually think they are very pretty. And the one that I think is very, very pretty is the red one. And that is, I don't know which one that is though. Let me see if I can read. That's the chocolate truffle one. Maybe you know why I kind of like the chocolate truffle one. It's because I can see on the swatches that there is a red shimmer in there. So yeah, the other one also looks really pretty. But yeah, I don't need it though, because I have a bunch of new palettes from iHeart Revolution that I need to get through. But I would love that red one. Yeah, I do think that the formula of the chocolate bar palettes keeps getting better and better. So there's that. Let me know down below if you want it, if you have it, and all that goodness. The next thing that I have is from Makeup Obsession. It's a new drop. That's what they say. Introducing the latest additions to the Feels family and your new go-to primer. It says here, get ready to feel yourself in three shimmering shades of Feels Diamond Highlighters. Formulated to be applied with your fingers for maximum impact. Can be used on the face, collarbone, shoulders. Wow, shoulders. That's a new word. And anywhere the light touches. They retail for £5, €6 or $7 each. And yes, I know it's technically €5.99. But that's too much trouble. So six is what you... It's, yeah, okay. It also says here,
take your lips to the next level with three shades of lips, Feels Lip Toppers. Transform the look of your favorite lip product or wear alone for a shimmering glossy finish that will power up your pout. Retail £4, €5 or €6. And introducing All A Blur Pore Blurring Primer in a solid stick component so you can apply directly to the face. This primer diffuses fine lines, blurs pores and creates a prepped and even base for makeup application. Retails £10, €11 or €15. All available at revolutionbeauty.com, coming to Boots UK on the 20th of November.
I need a sip of water after that. So, they already had a face palette and a... eyeshadow palette in this range. So yeah, let me know down below what you feel about it. I was kind of interested in the primer stick, but then again, I have a bunch of primers here. I still really would like to try the Milk Hydra Blur, because I kind of need something that's sticky, that sticks to my face. That's it. Yeah. So yeah, let me know down below if you have tried anything from this line and how it is. Is that the last drugstore thing I have? I think it is. Yeah, I think it is. I'm not sure. Let's go to this one then. This is the new Holiday 2019 collection from Kylie Cosmetics. It includes
a lip kit, that's a matte liquid lipstick and a pencil in Naughty List for $29. A Santa Claus North Pole eyeshadow palette, 16 shades for 48. A mini lip collection for 36. A red liquid eyeliner for 18. Two lipstick ornaments, $17 each. A high gloss collection for 36, four-piece brush collection for 35, blush and highlighter duo for 20, illuminating face primer 28, illuminating setting spray 26, two shimmer eye glazes, $20 each, okay, the complete bundle for $320, and Kylie Holiday Faves bundle for $170 with a white and red packaging will be available November 19th, 3 p.m. online at Kylie Cosmetics.
Wow. Yeah. You know, some things look really pretty, I'm not going to lie, but it's just way above my price range. And to be quite honest with you, I'm not really, getting all worked up about Kylie anyway. It's not for me. Let me know if it is for you and if you are excited about it. Okay, let's go to this next, which is from Lethal Cosmetics. It is called Scatter and it is their first official face product. Let's see here, it's called Scatter, a vibrant shifting violet blue. It's one of six shades that will be making up their brand new wavelength highlighter range. I also saw swatching pictures of two models. I will put one or maybe both up here. It looked really, really pretty. I still really want to try Lethal Cosmetics. And I will someday. I keep saying that every time I talk about them. But yeah, looks very, very pretty. This is all I know. If I know more, I will let you know. The next thing is also from Lethal Cosmetics. It is the Lumen Lip Gloss. This never sticky glistening lip gloss formula in 9 unique wearable shades will launch with the rest of their new lineup. Mark your calendars because the complete Dream Sign collection drops Friday, November 29th at 10 a.m. CET. Is that Black Friday? I never know. Because Black Friday... yeah, it is becoming more of a thing now, but it wasn't until... maybe 2 years ago or something along those lines. Because it's very American. But yeah, we do love a good bargain. So yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah, it is Black Friday. They will also have Black Friday specials running at the same time. So don't be afraid to indulge those wish lists. Maybe. Yeah. You never know. I will keep my eye on them, but they launch on Black Friday. I don't know any more than that. But yeah, it is a lot already. Let me know down below if you are excited and if you are planning to picking anything up. Let's go to, yeah, why not? Let's go to Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics because she revealed the holiday collection. I don't know what is it with those kind of influencer biggies. Apparently everything is a game changer and never been done before and so very, very unique. It's not really. It's highlighters, people. It looks pretty. The products look very pretty, but, you know, please don't be fooled. Buy it if you think it is something that you would like. Please do not buy it because it is Jaclyn Hill and that's the only reason, because I think you can get better quality products seeing her swatching her own products. Remember that. You know, swirling her finger in a pan 10 times. Yeah, I can kind of build anything up then. So please be wise and use your judgment. As you can probably hear, I'm not very, very excited about it. However, there is... what did she call it again? The mood lights, I think she called it. They remind me... It is the mood lights is loose and it's kind of a skin finish product. It reminds me kind of the hourglass powder that I love so much. But that is so, so expensive. So... If that one performs the same, and I'm going to wait for reviews because I know they will be there, hers is a lot cheaper and is in more colors. So that is one that I'm kinda interested-ish in. The rest, not so much. But what is in the collection? You have two palettes. I don't know why I do three. You have two palettes, one for light to medium skin tone and then one for deeper skin tone. They looked pretty, not revolutionary. But pretty, nonetheless. Then she had Beaming Light Loose Highlighters in 5 shades. She also had the Mood Light Luminous Powder in 5 shades. And then 3 brushes. A Mood Light Powder Brush, an Accent Light Highlighter Brush, and then a Beaming Light Highlighter Brush. It launches the 26th of November at Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics. So, yeah, guys. It's not really revolutionary. I do hope, though, that this launch goes better than her last one. Well, I'm almost tempted to say it cannot get any worse, but yeah, I'm not going to say that because you never know. But I do hope that this launch goes well for her, and I do wish her all the best. I do think that she is exaggerating a lot, but I also understand that she needs to sell her own products. So yeah, what can you say about a highlighter, you know? I don't know. Let me know down below if you are excited, if you plan on picking anything up, and if you plan to pick up that mood powder, so not the highlighter powder, but the kind of a finishing powder, let me know how it is, and if you have the hourglass powder, compare the two and let me know, because I'm curious. I think that that powder kind of retails for somewhere in the $30 range from Jaclyn, so that's always better than $50, is it not? So yeah, for the rest, yeah. I'm not really getting any excited about it, to be quite honest with you. But I also do not follow Jaclyn Hill. I have never followed Jaclyn Hill. She's not my kind of people. It doesn't matter though. But yeah, it is what it is. I do wish her all the best. Let's go to this one next, which is a collaboration between Tribe Beauty Box and Angelica Nykvist here on YouTube. Angelica has curated a box specifically for Tribe. And I will leave Angelica's reveal video down in my description box. Go check it out. She explains what's in the box. She shows what's in the box. She also explains how you can order it and the codes that you can use to do so. So yeah, you can get it everywhere, or at least I think you can. There is a US site. There is also a UK site and a European site. I don't know though if it is also available in Australia and New Zealand. You know, there, I don't know, but I do know it's available in Europe because I checked. I know that. So yeah, the box retails for $35. And you can use discount codes and all that goodness. I think it's very, very cool that she got the opportunity to do this. I wanted to order the box, but I have so many new things that the next thing that I want to order, I really, really, really want to have. Does that make any sense? I hope the box is a success and it sells out very, very quickly. Maybe it's even sold out now. I don't know. But yeah, let me know down below if you have ordered it, if you want it, and all that goodness. And congratulations to Angelica. I think it's amazing. So yeah. Okay, let's go next to Amy Hart's Beauty. It says here, Happy Friendsgiving available already. I'm pre-filming, so I can say available tonight, but it does not really matter because I am pre-filming this a few days in advance. So yeah, it is available already. It's 10 new colors inspired by all things fall. You get 5 mattes and 5 shimmers. You get cranberry, which is a deep wine, saucy muted plum, pumpkin bright in your face red orange, pie is 3.14 is a muted orange, femme illy is antique gold, heirloom muted mustard, pine a dimensional green with tiny specks of gold, neat much is a fair chartreuse, ham is better is a cocoa shimmer with pink shift. Ooh, that sounds interesting actually. And then turkey is a yellow beige brown. They look really pretty. I really like this color story actually. I think it's a really pretty color story. I haven't tried Amy Hart's Beauty. If you have, let me know. Let's go to the next thing, which I was... I was sent this post actually. It's from Moira Cosmetics. And they are based in Los Angeles. This is the Mystic Shadow series. It's now available. 4 eyeshadow palettes, Spell on You, Never Ending Lights, Soul of Fire, and Glow and Gleam. So, do not. So, let's look at them then. I think, first off, I am, oh wait, they retail for $19 each. Oh, and I have the names now as well, so that's good. I actually like all the palettes. Some have a little bit more brown. So the, let's see, the A Spell on You palette and Glow and Gleam palette have the most browns. And then, so let me point. A Spell on You palette is the one with the yellow, then hot pink and kind of a tealy color. Then the one that is above that is... Never Ending Lights palette, which is very pretty. Then the one down is the Glow and Gleam. In that corner is Glow and Gleam. And then here is Soul of Fire. I kind of like the Glow and Gleam. And I kind of like the Never Ending Lights. So the top two actually, the ones that are there. Wait, let's see. There, that row. Yes, yes. They are... kind of spread out like butterfly wings. I'm not hating the layout actually. I don't mind a layout like this. And especially because it's symmetrical. I'm weird like that maybe. But yeah. I don't think that $19 is a very bad price for a palette like this. Let me know if you have tried them. I haven't. I think they ship internationally. But I'm not sure. They're vegan and cruelty free. They're based in LA. It looks pretty, guys. Let me know if you have tried them. Yeah. Give us intel down in the comment section. And let us talk about it. Let's go to... sure, why not? Let's go to Laura Lee. Because this is her holiday collection. It has dropped. No, do not do that. It has dropped. And it is 2 face palettes and a bunch of lippies. Let's see. You have the Glazed Lid Kit. Which is the kit for the lighter skin tones, I think. It's shades Diamond, Glow Gal, Rosé All Day and Cinnamon Sugar. Then the Bronzed Lid Kit has Yacht Club, Rose Goals, Gold Rush and On The Glow. Each palette retails for $19 each. You can buy them together for $30. You can also buy 1 palette and then the lip trio for $39. The complete collection is $49. The liquid lipsticks are in the colors Mai Tai, Coral Pop and Cabana. They're pretty. I'm not really excited about this. But maybe you are. Let me know. I don't think that the pricing is bad though. So there's that. I actually always thought that Laura Lee was more expensive than this, to be quite honest with you. Let's go to... what's this? Oh yeah, this is because it's Australian. That's why I wanted to mention it. It is the limited edition Models Prefer... Oh? Prefer O? Models Prefer Australia, I think it is. Yeah, I think that's it. And 10 Hennessy Carp Collection. It's a collaboration. Has launched online at Priceline Australia and in select stores. The collection includes How Good Is Bread? Carp colored eyeshadow palette for 25 Australian bucks. I don't know how to use any of this essential. Wait, I don't know how to use any of this. Yes, that's what it's called. Essential four-piece brush set for 40 Australian dollars. I can't apply false lashes. Is a waterproof mascara which retails for 16 Australian dollars. It is way too brown for me. Even if I lived in Australia, it is way too brown for me. But I do really like this collection. And I think that we need to kind of broaden our focus. Not only for, US or UK, but also Australian, New Zealand and Canada. And that is what I try to do. If I find brands from those regions, I always, or at least try to mention them anyway to you. I think this looks really cute. I think this is fun. I think the pricing is nice, but I don't know. Let me know down below if you're from Australia. Let me know if you like this collection. Maybe you have tried something from this. Let me know down below. I think it's cute though. Okay, so I have another Australian brand, I think, and that is Ela Cosmetics or Ela Cosmetics. It's the Queen of Hearts brush set. It's available now. It retails for 65 Australian dollars and contains 5 brushes with handles full of hearts. And they look cute. That was what I wanted to mention. Let me know if you have tried Ela Cosmetics and how their brushes are. Let's go next to Makeup Maniacs Cosmetics, because this is a picture of their holiday palette. It is the perfect holiday glitz and glam with their Christmas anniversary palette. Velvet foils, buttery mattes and dazzling glitters goes well with any glam filled occasion. It is retailing for 24 bucks and discount codes are welcome. I like this palette. I just wish that the center, the three shades in the middle from top to bottom are pressed glitters. I wish those were shimmers. I so hope that kind of the pressed glitter thingy will be in this year and will not go with us to 2020. For me, you know, I like them less. I don't really go for pressed glitters, but I like them even less in small palettes. Like for instance, ColourPop's 9-pan palettes. I think it is a very, very hefty waste of space. This is a bigger palette, but still, yeah, I get it. But I wish that they would just put in the shimmers and then if they want glitters in this color scheme, do them separate, you know? Please do that. Please do that. It looks pretty. It does look really, really pretty. And if the middle three shades were not pressed glitters, I would be seriously tempted to get this palette. Because I do think it's really Christmassy. I think it's cute. I think it's fun. So, yeah. Let me know what you think down below. Okay. And if you love pressed glitters in eyeshadow palettes, that's obviously totally fine. I don't specifically hate pressed glitters. I just think it's a waste of space because I don't use them enough. That's basically it. Next, let's go to Monique Boulay. Because she is releasing... Yeah, palettes all the time actually. But this one was especially grabbing my interest because of the obviously red shimmers in there. This is called the Winter Princess palette. It is 15 brand new colors. They are now available on her Etsy. I have the color description here as well. You have Aurora, which is a pastel purple highlighter. Then you have Narnia, which is a pastel blue highlighter. Then Sleeping Beauty, pastel rosy highlighter. And then you get the eyeshadows, I think. Frozen is a cool frosted baby blue. Sea Witch is a dark sparkle sea blue. Cherry Kiss is a bright cherry red. Ultramarine Pink is a silvered pink with blue undertone. Ooh. Chrome Lilac is a metallic lilac. Arctic Fox Mute Satin Periwinkle. I don't know exactly what a periwinkle color is, but I will see so when I swipe in a minute. Winterberry is a dark pinkish red. Then Cyber Grape is dark purple blue. Andromeda, super sparkly dark purple. Strawberry, bright pink red. Pink Taffy is a bubblegum pink. And then Candy Hearts is a pink with gold sparkles. Let me see. What was a Cherry Kiss? Oh yeah, bright cherry red. That was the one that I... but there are actually a lot of very, very pretty shades in this palette, if I'm being completely honest. But yeah, that red is very, very pretty. Cherry Kiss. Oh, Cyber Grape's also very pretty, by the way. But yeah, very pretty. Let me know if you have tried her brand. I know that Liora has a code with them. I will leave the code down in the description box. So, just so you know, because I know that she has tried M Cosmetic, Monique Boulay, a few times actually. And again, she has a code with them and it saves you, I think it saves you 5%, but I'm not sure. So yeah, it looks very pretty. I don't actually know if you can buy the shades loose though. I will check it out because I'm intrigued. Yes. Okay, let's go to the pigment palette. Wait, the pigment palace next, because I have a new product alert. It's the Slay Essentials palette. It's available for pre-order and it launches. Oh, it has already launched as well. It has launched on the 15th. It looks really pretty. Yeah, half neutral, half colorful, or actually more colorful than neutral, if I'm being completely honest. I think this is actually a nice range of colors. I don't know if the white, I hope the white is a shimmer and not a matte. But that's me, because otherwise I don't, I get a matte black in a palette. I usually don't get a matte white, but that is because I don't use a matte white. But yeah, let me see if I can kind of figure out something more. It's vegan. It's now available, but why don't I know what it retails for, people? That would be so nice. Okay, so the Modern Royalty palette retail. I think it's around $25, I'm guessing. And I'm also guessing that it is a matte white, but I'm not sure. Yeah, damn. I think it is a matte white, which I think personally is a shame. But again, I don't use matte white. I do think it looks really pretty. I really do think it's pretty. I, again, don't know what it retails for. I'm not going to go on the website because it takes too long. I think it is around $25. I will leave the website down below and you can go and check it out. So I have a sneak peek from Kaleidos Makeup because they are working on lips. So yeah, there will be 3 shades of gloss. They will be called Lucid Lip Gloss. And 3 shades of liquid lipsticks. They will be called Lip Tonic Liquid Lipstick. You see the video playing, or at least I think you see the video playing. I'm not sure if I will take stills from the video or just show the video. But I'm very excited actually. They look pretty. So yeah. I like very much the aesthetics of Kaleidos Makeup. I think they are doing something different. Their highlighters, for instance, are unique. Are new and fresh, Miss Jacqueline. But yeah, they look really pretty. I still have not tried Kaleidos as well. I really, really want to though, because I love the aesthetics of their brand. And I love the... I just really want to try them, guys. I'm not going to lie. Yeah, I really want to try them very, very much so, if I'm being completely honest. So yeah, there's that. Let's go next to Peachy Queen, because they are releasing or have released already the I'll Be There For You Friends Inspired palette. It's available now, yeah. 16 shades that would make you feel nostalgic, like Smelly Cat, How You Doing? Pivot, Naked Guy, Yemen and more. Shimmers and mattes to create a 90s vibe. It retails for, say, $30. And it is available at peachyqueen.com. It's so cool. We are actually having a rerun of Friends on... Is it Comedy Central? I think it is. But we are also having a rerun of Dharma and Greg. And I love Dharma and Greg. That show is so funny. But I also really love Friends. So when I saw this, I was like, ooh, this is cute. I also like the color story though. So yeah, there is that. I think that the colors are nice and funky. I don't specifically see Friends in the color, because the makeup there was basically the 90s, but not neon-y, actually. Yeah, a little bit more of a 90s, grungy, classical 90s, but not really neon-y. But yeah, I do think it's pretty. I really like the color story. I like Friends. I like the aesthetics. Let me know down below what you think of it. So yeah, let me know down below if you have tried Peachy Queen and if it is all that. Basically. So yeah, let's go next to Blush Tribe, because she has released the Christmas Titanium Dust Bauble Bundle. It's available for purchase on blushtribe.com, and they are very pretty. Especially the red. Now, I have... Is this a titanium? I think this is a titanium dust as well. The Lila color that I got with the Lila 2 palette. It's actually really... I think I need a red one. I already have a golden one. Damn. She was having a sale recently and I'm still eyeing her pastel tribe. But yeah, no, I do think I'm going to pass. But this red titanium dust, I would not hate owning at all. I don't know if I do want the bundle though. Maybe. I'll check it out. That's red. Ooh. Let's go to the next one. I think I'm almost done. Yeah, I'm almost done. Well, this is from Tracy's Powder Room. I had never heard of them. I actually think this was kind of like an ad on Instagram, but it captured my attention and I saved it. This is a Jolly and Bright collection in loose pigment eyeshadow. Wait, in loose pigment / eyeshadow, it's available now. It's 4 vibrant colors, each in 5-gram jars with sifters from left to right. Oh wait, I also have a picture with the names on it. So you have Sugar Plum, Merry Mint, Santa's Cheeks and Rosy Flamingo. I think I also had swatches. Let me see. I saw swatches on the finger, yes. So here I have the swatches as well. Swatches as well. The Sugar Plum is bluer than the Rosy Flamingo. But the Santa Cheeks and the Merry Mint, oh, they're very pretty. I like this collection, actually. I think this is very cute. I don't know. Do I know what they retail for? I don't think so. But it is... I'm actually... I'm trying to find the pricing on their Instagram. But I'm kind of scrolling through their Instagram. It is... definitely worth checking out their site, because they have a bunch of very, very pretty stuff. So yeah, I don't know. They have an Etsy shop. Just so you know, they are handmade. It's handmade in Texas, USA, vegan and cruelty-free. Go check it out, because it's very pretty, guys. If you like multi-chromes and duochrome-y stuff, pretty, go check it out. Yes. The next thing is from a post from Makeup World News. She was tagged by one of her followers or sent this picture. This is actually a Cheetos palette. It retails for $16 at Forever 21. When I saw this, I just needed to show you guys. It is... so you have an eyeshadow palette. It's actually a Cheetos Flaming Hot and Riley Rose. At Forever 21, I don't, yeah. And you also have a highlighter bronzer, which is not really functional, I think, looking at it, but okay. And you also have a lip gloss kit. If you like Cheetos, go check out your Forever 21. I thought this was so fucking cute. Do we have a Forever 21 in the Netherlands? I think we do. But I don't think that we have something like this. I don't have a Forever 21 near me, I believe. And I think that the Forever 21s that we have in the Netherlands are mostly clothing. But I just thought this was hilarious, so I wanted to mention it. The last thing that I have is this. It is... I was kind of debating naming it or not. But yeah, anyway, this is from Tati. Well, this is actually from Trend Mood, but it is Tati Beauty revealing apparently in one of her videos a new product coming out on Black Friday. And obviously, the product is a game changer. It's so different. It changes it all and it really helps everybody's beauty routine. I don't know. Why is everything revolutionary these days? I don't think there is a lot revolutionary, because I think that a lot of things have been done. So I actually cannot wait to see what she thinks is revolutionary. Let me know what your thought is. What do you think that is so revolutionary for your beauty routine? New pills? I know, lash growth serum? No, that's no. Maybe a washcloth or a cleanser. I don't know. Let me know down in the comment section what you think. So guys, that was it. And before I go and close off the video, did you leave your guess down below in the comment section what you thought the palette was that I created this with? Shall I show you? It is this one. Did you guess? Let me show you the inside real quick, unless maybe you know what it looks like. But here she is. I don't know what it has to do with popcorn, but yeah. This is what came out of this palette today. So yeah, if you have made it this far, leave a popcorn emoji down in the comment section. And let's start a secret club. Secret popcorn club. Maybe you have nice popcorn recipes. Leave them down below as well. So yeah, we can start our own popcorn cooking club or something along those lines. But yeah guys, that was it. That was it for my Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases of this week. Thank you so much for sending me stuff that you find interesting and tag me and all that goodness. I love it. I really, really love it. And I try to, I think I mentioned everything that I got sent this week. I hope so. I hope I didn't forget anything. Usually I save it when I see it. Does that make any sense? I hope so. Anyway, I'm rambling. I need to close off the video because it is actually, it's almost 8 o'clock at night here. So that is very, very late for me to film. Usually I'm kind of reclining on my couch and being fabulous. But I really wanted to film this video today for you. Okay. I really need to close off the video because my falsie is loose. So let's close it off like this, because that is sexy. Anyway, if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. Going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I hope you don't get nightmares of my falsie about to fall off. But yeah, guys, have an amazing evening. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys. I don't care that there's an update for me for my laptop. No. Go away. Pretty curated. It goes well together. I think, I don't know what to say, guys. It's pretty. I don't know. It's getting late and I'm thirsty. Wow. That was loose the entire video. Sexy.